Hey everybody, it's 40War. Welcome back to Mass Effect 2. The last time we finished the tutorial mission, and well, we learned we're working with the enemy. Cerberus. Which makes sense to the saying, we have met the enemy, he is us. So yes, we're working with terrorists and gigantic assholes. You remember Cerberus, you know, with their little work with the Arachni and the Thorian Creepers and the like. But now we're going to talk to the Lucid Man in this part and see why the hell Cerberus decided to resurrect Shepard. And completely defy all the laws of nature. Also, I always wonder, what is behind the Elusive Man? Is that a planet? A sun? If you look at it closely, it looks like it's moving, so it almost, it could be maybe breathing. Unnecessary precautions. See, look, it's moving in the background. I have no idea what the heck that is, to be honest with you. It could be water. But honestly, I don't know. Also, awesome music here. This is good music. I think it's one thing gets lost in a shuffle in Mass Effect 2, and I didn't realize this when I was first playing through the game. I started realizing it the last couple times through, like a suicide mission, this theme right here, another theme later on. They all really are really, really good. Mass Effect 1 has a better soundtrack, no question, but 2 has some very underrated stuff here, because you just don't see this stuff until now. But anyway, enough delaying. I mean, I can admire a lot of things about this game, and I do. I have my complaints about some of the repetitive stuff, but yeah, the music. It's really, really good.
From what I hear, I cost you a fortune. Why'd you do it?
For the defense and preservation of humanity. I didn't spend 2 years and billions of credits bringing you back to serve as a common soldier. But humanity is up against the greatest threat of our brief existence.
The Reapers.
Good to see your memory still intact. How are you feeling?
I noticed a few upgrades. I hope you didn't replace anything really important.
We tried to keep you as intact as possible. We need Shepard, just as you were when you defeated Sovereign.
What are the Reapers doing that made you decide to bring me back?
We're at war. No one wants to admit it, but humanity is under attack. While you've been sleeping, entire colonies have been disappearing. Human colonies. We believe it's someone working for the Reapers, just as Saren and the Geth aided Sovereign. You've seen it yourself. You bested all of them. That's just one reason we chose you.
You could have trained an entire army for what you spent to bring me back.
You're unique. Not just in ability or what you've experienced, but in what you represent. You stood for humanity at a key moment. You're more than a soldier. You're a symbol. And I don't know if the Reapers understand fear, but you killed one. They have to respect
you. Just like Miranda said in the beginning. They'll follow Shepard. He's a hero, a bloody icon.
Sovereign was trying to harvest all life in the galaxy. Why would the Reapers target a few human colonies?
Hundreds of thousands of colonists have vanished. I'd say that fits the definition of harvesting. Nobody's paying attention because it's random, and the attacks occur in remote locations. I don't know why they've suddenly targeted humanity. Maybe you got their attention when you killed one of them.
I don't like one thing about this. You notice I'm going through the investigates. That Alliance said was over here, now it's over here. That happens. I have no idea why it happens, it just does. I think it's kind of silly.
Fighting a war doesn't seem like Cerberus. Why are you involved?
We're committed to the advancement and preservation of humanity. If the Reapers are targeting us, trying to wipe us out, Cerberus will stop them. If we wait for politicians or the Alliance to act, no more human colonies will be left.
If what you say is true, if the Reapers are behind this, I'd consider helping you.
I'd be disappointed if you accepted any of this without seeing for yourself. I have a shuttle ready to take you to Freedom's Progress, the latest colony to be abducted. Miranda and Jacob will brief you.
Is this a volunteer job, or am I being volunteered?
You always have a choice, Shepard. If you don't find the evidence we're both looking for, we can part ways. But first, go to Freedom's Progress. Find any clues you can. Who's abducting the colonies? Do they have any connection to the Reapers? I brought you back. It's up to you to do the rest.
I think it would have been better if the Elusive Man decided to be more badass about it. He said, I had the power to bring you in this world, and by God, I had the power to take you out of it. Kind of like the Bill Cosby show. He says that to, Bill Cosby says that to Theo all the time. And some of the other kids. But I digress. Nice thing here is now you can actually customize your armor, unlike in one where you were stuck with the predetermined paint jobs that they gave. You know, if you got a Predator armor, it was always green. You know, like. And of course, remember that, that Phoenix armor, the white and pink. Yeah, fuck that noise. My personal favorite colors, really, color combinations are black and dark red. Or a blue and silver. I'm having a little trouble trying to get dark red and black. But the blue and silver I made earlier, and I kind of like it. I'm not bringing a helmet, because real men don't need helmets. Unless, of course, death is involved. This just basically affects the shine, I think. Nothing more. I'll fix that later. But anyway, you don't need to really see this. I'm just gonna do this off screen. That actually doesn't look too bad now. I mean, yeah. No real angle with the lighting the way it is. Here we are. So yeah, found wife, found a dark blue. Kinda cool.
The Elusive Man is very impressed with you. I'm eager to see if you can live up to his expectations on this mission.
What's the matter, Lawson? Worried you're not his favorite anymore?
I've proven my value to the Elusive Man. Let's hope you're able to do the same.
Are you naturally this bitchy, or is it just me?
I have the utmost respect for your abilities, Shepard. It's your motivations that concern me. I believe in what Cerberus stands for. Only time will tell if you prove to be an asset or a liability to our cause.
The one thing about Miranda I do like, though, is she is blunt and to the point.
Tell me a little about yourself.
Just like this.
Worried about my qualifications? I can crush a mech with my biotics or shoot its head off at 100 yards. Take your pick.
That's pretty blunt. Miranda is kind of cool. I do like Miranda to an extent.
We've got an assignment. We can talk about
she's not
it
my favorite, but she's definitely not my least favorite, I'll tell you that much. She's got some pretty good qualities to her. How blunt can you get?
I'm glad the Elusive Man convinced you to join us, Commander.
And of course, Rex takes the cake when it comes to bluntness.
I just want to find out what happened to those missing people. I still don't trust Cerberus.
Noted. Do you trust me, Commander?
I haven't made up my mind about you yet.
At least you're giving me a chance. Most Alliance soldiers hate Cerberus on principle.
You said you served in the Alliance?
5 years in total. Stationed all over the galaxy. Even spent a couple of years as a Corsair.
I've never heard of the Corsairs.
It was an Alliance initiative. They hired independent starship captains and used them for missions that fell outside official Alliance jurisdiction. Technically, we weren't part of the Alliance. If we ever got caught, they could disavow any knowledge of us. We were supposed to be free from restrictions and rules. But there was still enough red tape to sink a cruiser. I finally just gave up.
Why did you join Cerberus?
I guess I just got tired of never making a difference.
Sounds a lot like Garrus in the first game.
So much of what I did in the Alliance seemed pointless. I thought things would change after the attack on the Citadel. Humanity was finally invited to join the Council. But nothing changed. Politics, bureaucracy, same bullshit, different leaders. Cerberus is different. When colonies go missing, we don't commission a team to write a report to figure out what the hell to do about it. We just go and find out.
That's all for now.
Yes, sir.
Jacob is not one of my favorite characters in the game because, I mean, it sounds a lot like he could be another Garrus, right? Right now? Just the way he goes about it, you know, the red tape, all that good stuff, just like Garrus, want to make a difference. That's probably the only thing you're ever going to learn about Jacob through the whole game, which sucks. Miranda, at least there's some depth to her. Jacob, no. None. Nada. Zilch. And that's, yeah, you're going to notice this. Jacob gets boring really quick. Really. I think that's why a lot of people don't really care for him. So anyway, here we are at the level up screen. It's much different than Mass Effect 1 where you just put points in and go on down the line. You eventually unlock powers as you go up. Now, as you put things to certain ranks, these powers will go up. These powers will be unlocked. And you have to spend more points to keep going up. So I spend 2 points for this, 3 points for that, 4 points for the end, or 1 point here. you're always going to want to have this up because this is going to raise your Paragon and your Renegade scores to their highest potential. See? See, there's a little boost there. Not much for right now. Doesn't have to be much for right now, but it's going to be important later on. And I'm going to want to have Incinerate, because Incinerate is one of the best powers, in my opinion, all around. I'll unlock Hacking later on. And the ammos just make you good against certain enemies and make your weapons a little more powerful, do additional damage to the like. Can be helpful, but there is a reason why I don't really care for upping these. Because certain characters have these powers too. And as you go up to the top right here, you will, every time you get to the fourth, to the highest level, there'll be a split where you can choose between two awesome assets. You see right here, heavy ammo, which makes your ammo really powerful, or squad ammo, which means everybody in your squad gets your ammo. And I like exploiting that power when my squad mate gets it, so I'll have squad ammo from the squad mate. You won't see it now, obviously, because it's way down the line, but you'll notice it later on, trust me. Anyway, I did that. You have to spend your squad points. That's why I did it now before you leave. And, well, yeah. And notice I got some numerous import bonuses. Because I beat Mass Effect 1, I get, you know, an experience boost, I get some credits, I get minerals. I also, because I had a rich character, got the rich achievement, I got 100,000 more credits. Pretty helpful. Pretty helpful indeed. Those credits are going to be going away very soon, trust me. There will always be more than enough credits for you to go through the game. But of course, if you want to get a lot of this stuff, or almost everything, you want to buy almost everything, you have to do most of the bypass and hack minigames, which suck, because they're always the same. Like I said, one of my least favorite parts of the game.
We should be there shortly, Shepard. The elusive man put us under your command. Do you have any orders?
Our first priority is to look for survivors.
That's unlikely, Commander. No one was left at the other colonies. They were completely deserted.
Be nice to find somebody. Anything's better than another ghost town.
Absolutely. Ghost towns are not fun. They're often really creepy. Heck, have you ever drove down that one road where it's like, no, there's nobody there, it looks like a piece of shit? You know, it looks really ghetto. That's when shit really gets scary, and even then, it creeps the shit out of me. I've driven through it a couple times, through neighborhoods like that, just, oh, scary. But now we have all our weapons. Yippee. As you see, Miranda comes equipped with a shuriken machine pistol. Machine pistol, everybody would pretty much have except for a soldier. Which is kind of like a poor man's assault rifle, but it's very powerful close range. Heavy pistol, which, well, I was using to start. Jacob has a shotgun. Shotgun characters are not very good because they tend to use their shotgun from non-ideal distances, like too far away. Also, I don't think a shotgun's really that necessary because a machine pistol up close does a ton of damage. Actually, maybe more so than a shotgun, to be honest. And at least a machine pistol has some sort of roll mid-range. Not very good from long distance, but I have a sniper rifle, which can cover that weakness pretty well. So yeah. And if you also look at their powers now, since I actually get a chance to level these up now. Jacob has pull. You saw what pull can do. But pull is limited to anybody that has a health bar only and no protection. Every character from now on will have protection, which means he can't use it until that gets taken care of. A definite drawback. But I'm going to up his pull for right now, because I kind of like having a high pull. Miranda, on the other hand, is going to be very useful throughout the entire game, unlike Jacob. Because Miranda's overload works against shields, warp is going to be great against armor and barriers. That is the three layers of protection, armor, shields, barriers. Most enemies will have only one of the three, some will have two. Like the really tough enemies will have two. But I like having both of these. And I definitely don't mind upping these right now. Miranda's going to be very helpful because of that. She's definitely going to be helpful because of her powers, unlike Jacob, who really just doesn't have much other than pull. And me, I have a few things, but right now I'm very good against anything with shields. I'm okay against anything with shields because of disruptor ammo, which is default, and because of incinerate, which will be helpful with armor. Anyway, enough about that. Let's go. Let's get into action. And now, I'm going to definitely show off why sniping is much better in this game than the first. But granted, I still want to try no-scoping things, but remember Mass Effect 1, where if you didn't have a high sniper rifle range, that scope would dance around like a Mexican jumping bean? Well, now it's different. Watch what's going to happen up first. A little help. Watch this. Slow down time because I'm in the inherent ability of the infiltrators. You can slow down time as you snipe. But as you see right there, the scope didn't move. I can control it without the thing dangling or dancing around like an idiot. Which is effing awesome. Okay, that time was dancing around, but I don't think that was because of me. I think that was because of the fact I was aiming like that. Just watch. See? The sniper rifle can... The Mantis sniper rifle is really good because I can one-hit kill a lot of things.
Someone reprogrammed them to attack on sight. We're not alone here.
Yep, we're not alone is right. One thing I don't like about the sniper rifle here is... so little ammo. Oh my god. I used up over half my ammo for this thing already. How bad is that? Oh, don't get me wrong. I'll find ammo eventually for it, but... come on. Which is why getting an upgrade for the sniper rifle early on is kind of helpful. Especially if you like a sniper rifle. 2,000 credits for that. Not bad. And here's the other inherent ability of my, infiltrator. Every character has an inherent power, which is usually stationed to the Y button to start. You can map certain powers. Tactical cloak means I can turn invisible, but I can't regenerate shields or health. Pretty awesome. Well, for a temporary amount of time. Every character has one, like soldier would have, adrenaline rush would slow down time, engineer can summon a combat drone, things like that. So let's show an action. It also makes your attacks more powerful.
Alert.
See, watch. They don't even know where I am. That Fenris mech does not see me. Neither does the Loki mech, for that matter. And like I said, this thing, close range, is a tough cookie, but I almost died because I almost ran out of I almost ran out of a clip. Yeah, just a little spy punch. I like punching things out of spite. It's fun.
Stop right there!
Fraza, you said you'd let me handle this. Wait, Shepard?
I'm not taking any chances with Cerberus operatives.
Put those weapons down! Shepard? Is that... you're alive?
Yep, that's Tally. From the first game. The first squadmate we meet. We don't know how exactly she escaped, but she somehow escaped and, well... what a coincidence. 2 years later, and who you meet up with? One of your squadmates from before.
Remember when I gave you that Geth data, Tally? Did it help you complete your pilgrimage?
Yes, it did. Fraza, weapons down. This is definitely Commander Shepard.
Why is your old commander working for Cerberus?
I don't know. Maybe we should ask.
I nearly died, Tally.
Actually, you did die. Shut
Cerberus
up.
Cerberus spent 2 years rebuilding me. They want me to investigate attacks on human colonies.
Likely story. No organization would commit so many resources to bring back one soldier.
You haven't seen Shepard in action, Praza. Trust me, it was money well spent.
You think Praza would have figured out by now that Shepard actually saved, saved everybody?
He was here on pilgrimage.
You know, just saying, I think you would realize. But yeah, I think Tali would have reminded him of that.
Isn't that a little strange? Quarian visiting a remote human colony?
Quarians can choose where they go on pilgrimage. Vitor liked the idea of helping a small settlement. He was always nervous in crowds.
She means that he was unstable. Combine that with damage to his soot CO2 scrubbers and an infection from an open-air exposure, and he's likely delirious.
When he saw us landing, he hid in a warehouse on the far side of town. We suspect he also programmed the mechs to attack anything that moved.
Vitor's the only one who can tell us what happened here. We should work together to find him.
Good idea. You'll need two teams to get past the drones anyway.
Now we're working with Cerberus?
No, Praza. You're working for me. If you can't follow orders, go wait on the ship. Head for the warehouse through the center of the colony. We'll circle around the far side and draw off some of the drones to clear you a path.
Make sure to keep in radio contact.
Will do. Good luck, Shepard. Whatever happens, it's good to have you back.
Let's roll. And actually, we're at 22 minutes right now. But we realize we're not alone. We met Tally, and yeah. Didn't realize this until actually, like, last playthrough. Tally's the only Quarian in Mass Effect 1. How pathetic is that? I've only played the game, what, like 5-6 times? I think I should know this by now. But yeah, we have confirmed something. She's not the only one of her kind. Although, for what it's worth, most of the other Quarians in Mass Effect, I am not big fans of. I'm not a big fan of. Tally's like my favorite Quarian in the game by about 1,500 light years. Something like that. But anyway, we met Tally, and we pretty much are halfway through Freedom's Progress, actually. So yeah, next time, probably finish off Freedom's Progress and find Vitor, hopefully. See you then, 40 Warriors signing off.